Hello guys, so today I'm going to do a review of my new laptop. It is Lenovo IdeaPad and its model number is 5700U, and actually I purchased it in I think 2 to 3 months back, and after that I didn't get chance to review it, but I think I have used enough right now and I think it is good time to review it. So talking about its configuration first, it's having 16 GB of RAM, and also it has 512 GB of SSD. Okay, so this is the major configuration, and it is not an Intel processor; it has an AMD processor. So it is having a Ryzen 7 processor, and if I open it just first time, you can see it will be started automatically without requiring to press the power button. Okay, this is a feature given in the Lenovo laptop. You can turn it off, but I have kept it on. Let me open it. I cannot open it with one hand. I have to use two hand. Okay, so this is one drawback of this laptop. Like in MacBook, you know, you can just simply open it like that, but it is not possible. And okay, before I just open it, I will show you what is this width and like how slim it is, right? So you can see it's quite slim, and if I see it from here as well, you can see it like this. And if I go to the back of this, so we can see it here like this. So it is having a weight of 1.66 kilo, I mean, which is mentioned in the Flipkart site. And so if I just open it now, so let me use my two hand, then only I can open it. Okay, just hold for a moment. Yeah, so now it's open, and you can see it is automatically turned on, right? And see, it's quick, really quick. Now it's asking me to give the password, or actually I have to use my fingerprint here because I have already configured it. So I will just touch my finger here. So you can see it instantly got turned on, right? I mean, I get logged in. So you can see how fast it is. So here you can see like the display quality is quite good. It is IPS display, and it is having a brightness of I think 300 something like that. I mean 300 nits or something. But I feel like if I place it, like you can see it here, I'm pressing the brightness button, like it's kind it's having the 50% brightness. So I will I will show you how good it is. How maximum brightness could be like this. So it's quite good, I believe, because in the I always use in my room only. I never used it outside of my room or like in the daylight condition. So I feel like it's quite good, and it has an anti-glare display as well. So you can view, if even though there will be no reflection, if you are, there is a sunlight behind your, something like where you are using your laptop, there is some sunlight or some kind of tube lights is there. So it will not make any problem for you because it has an anti-glare display, and the brightness is quite good, right? So I can just right now just let me decrease this brightness. So you can see the brightness is kind of 50% of it. Now if I zoom here, like you can see the battery percentage also, it is 61%. So maybe you have a question like, how is the battery backup in this laptop? So battery backup, which I get around 6 hours overall, I can say, like when I was watching few episodes of some web series, and there I got like around 6 hours of battery backup, even though I'm continuously watching those series. Not continuously, but in the gap of 2 hours, something like that. So I got around 5.5 to 6 hours, okay, on an average, even though I'm working like some programming or some other like technical things here. Also, I'm a technical person, and I use like some software like Eclipse and PyCharm, as you can see here. So those softwares, if I run use it, and it works very good, and I do not feel any lag if I have multiple tabs open in Chrome or in Edge browser, and I am using other application like PyCharm or any other heavy application. So it's quite great, and in terms of like handling those application without any lag because of its 16 GB RAM, because RAM optimization is also important in any laptop. So here also it's quite good, and now let me tell you a few things, like few other things. For example, the condition about the keyboards, right? So the keyboard is quite great. I mean, the pressing of these key buttons is fantastic. I do not have any complaint on it. And this touchpad, okay, this touchpad, you can see this touchpad is quite big, and there is no button here, but you can press it like this. Here also you can press it. Okay, I usually use mouse with it. So it's fine. It is having two ports on the right. Okay, so here you can see the ports. Okay, here you can see the two ports, two USB ports, and here I think this is the SD card reader. Okay, and here in this side we have some few more ports, like one is USB-C type ports, another is power cable. And I never use this USB-C type port. I think it can be used for power charging this laptop using your C type cable or something, but I never used it till now. And this is your HDMI I think port, and this is your headphone jack port. The sound quality of this laptop is decent. I would say not, I will not say it's best in this segment, because I think it could be a bit louder, but I do not have any complaint, because it's just works. I mean, I can show you that how it is good, how good it is. So let me open it something here, and let me open any YouTube video here. So just first let me check. Okay.
Writing's not that easy.
So you can see
Grammarly can help. This sentence
the sound is quite great.
Correct, but it's wordy and hard to read. It
yeah.
undermines the writer's message, and the word choice is bland.
So
Grammarly's cutting edge technology helps you craft.
Let me search any. Let me just search any song music, like.
With four new models showed
off. No copyrights.
New models with technology upgrade always come with new repair challenges.
Let me play it. Let me make it full volume. So this is the full volume, you can see it. And the screen quality, I mean, if you're watching any movies or something like that, it would be awesome, because you can see the bezels are very thin, and you will have a great experience. So no complaint on it. And I have also played some games in this laptop, and because of its Ryzen 7 processor, which like you can see the 5000 series, right? So it is handling quite good. I played like Asphalt 9, and I didn't play any other games. So it's quite good. I mean, it can handle Asphalt 9 quite easily. Maybe I can try some heavy games on it, but I am not a gamer. I mean, I'm not game lover or something. So just casual game. I have done some casual gaming, something like that. So apart from that, I mean, I can say it's quite decent. And if you have any question or anything, you can ask. So let me pause the music. So in summary, I can say. And one more thing I missed it, the price of this laptop. Okay, so in Flipkart I got some offer on it, and right now I think it is having a price of 68,000 in laptop in Flipkart site, and but I purchased it in 64,000, and also I did some exchange on my previous old laptop. So yeah, and this is something I can say. And apart from that, I think I have not missed anything. Battery backup I have covered. I have covered the screen quality. I have covered the keyboard, keypad. Okay, and Bluetooth connectivity is also fine. Wi-Fi is quite great. I mean, no complaint on it. And apart from that, handling of the softwares, that is also fine. Till now, no issues. I think I'm pretty much satisfied with this laptop. Hope it will not be having any problem in future. And that's it. Thank you. Thank you for watching.